So today I want to work on product categories, and I also want to work on some edge cases. And the first thing that I want to do is on this welcome page, I want to make sure that these featured products go to their product page. So let's head over to the text editor and make that work. So now we need to go to that welcome component and head down to where we're displaying the featured items. In here, we can go ahead and add a colon, and then the route will be shop show. And then we are going to add that feature slug. So that should work fine. Let's go to our browser and check it out. Go ahead and refresh. Okay. And if we click it, we are now on that home goods product. The next thing I want to do is if we go to the shop page, I've gone ahead and added an extra category here, and it doesn't have any products in it. So what's going to happen is when we click that test category, as you can see here, we don't have anything displayed, and we really should have something to indicate to the user that there are no products here. If you have downloaded the images that we are using from my Dropbox, the link is in the description, then you know that we have an image that we have not used yet. Let's go ahead and implement that to handle this edge case. Now, if we head over to our shop index page and go up to where we're displaying this, which would be right around here, we're going to add a div, and that div is going to have some classes on it. Okay, and then we're also going to put a VF on here. We're going to say products length equals 0. And then for this length now, we can put VLs. We're going to have an image, and that image is going to be that image that we have for that. And for the alt, we're just going to say these are not the droids you are looking for. So let's head back to the browser and see if that works. So we need to make sure we get our image, but the text is showing up, which is a good sign. And it looks like, okay, so first of all, it's like this. And JPEG, I believe, is JPEG. Let me go ahead and double check that down here. JPEG. Let's try it again. There it is. These aren't the droids you're looking for. Okay, and everything else works the same. So that edge case is taken care of. So now on to the products. We go to women's, and I want the first one so that we can manipulate it. Okay, as you can see here, we're displaying one first, and there are two items in here. Basically, what I want done is if there are less than five items, I want there to be a message up here saying limited supplies or something like that. And then if it's more than five, then it'll just have this. And then if it's out of stock altogether, then we will say sold out. Okay, so let's go ahead and make that work. Okay, we can close out these and head over to the shop page, the shop show page. And this is where we're listing out the quantities. If we head down to our data section, as I said when we were setting this up, I have two different quantities here. One is for the form and one is just sort of a generic quantity. And we also actually have the product quantity coming in from the controller. This quantity, I just want to have it set so that we can use it as selected. This form quantity is what we'll be sending in with the form, and then the product quantity is just what's coming from the product. The reason we didn't want to put this product quantity in this form is because when we go ahead to send it to the controller, the entire quantity of the product will be sent in with the controller. So if we put this product slug, and let's say our women's item that we just looked at has two of them, when we go in to send the form, it'll send in two. Whether or not we chose two, it will send two. So that's why we have them separated in this way. So let's head up here and start working on this. Let me shrink this down a bit. And these buttons we'll get to at a later time. But right up here where we're displaying our quantities, we are going to create first a template. And then in this template, we're going to say vif product quantity is less than or equal to zero. Now in here, we'll have a div with a class of MT4. And then a span with some classes. And then in here, we'll just say sold out. If there are less than or equal to zero product quantities, then we will display sold out. And I'm just going to copy this one, put it here. And now if product quantity is less than or equal to 5, we'll have a span class, text, we'll do yellow, 600, font semi-bold, and then we'll say only a few left. And now for here, we also need this same sort of drop-down thing that we have. So we'll copy this one and we'll put it under here and then it'll be the same. So the V model is form quantity. The options will display the quantities. It'll be looping over the product quantities. And then the quantity that we'll be displaying is whatever that quantity is whenever it's selected. And this selected, the quantity equals quantity, is coming from this variable that we have here where it's 1. So we always want it at 1 unless we select something else. So now here we'll do template. It'll say v else. And let me make sure this should be v else if and then v else. And then we can take this and bring this up. Okay, now let's just double check and make sure that that's got everything that we need. And let's head to the browser and make sure that that's coming through okay. Okay, so now since this one has 2, which means it's less than 5, we should get an error saying there are only a few left. Go ahead, refresh. Only a few left. Fantastic. Let's go ahead and change the values in the database so that we can see the other messages that we're supposed to be getting. Okay, so the first one is that women's one that we're looking at. Let's go ahead and change this to 0, and then we'll head back, refresh, and see if that works. Okay, so now we're sold out. Let's go ahead, change it back to, let's say, 10, and see what that does. And so now we have the first one displayed, and then this one will be selected, and that's cool. So that works. If you go down, you see that the one we selected is actually the one that's being highlighted automatically. Now, the last thing that I want to do on here is if this product is sold out, meaning the quantity is 0, we don't want this button to be displayed. So let's go ahead, change that in the database, and then we'll work on the code. Here, we'll make this 0, and then we'll head down to the button. And then here, all we'll need to do is if product quantity is greater than 0. Okay, let's give that a try. So now we don't even have a button anymore. Fantastic. I'm going to leave it here. If you guys are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to push the code up to GitHub. All of the links will be down in the description for you. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys next time.